Developing tonight in Minneapolis, investigators are searching for the cause of this massive fire that started at an encampment on the city's south side. This is the latest location for the Ninocasi camp.
You may remember the camp has relocated several times after being cleared by the city. This latest location where today's fire started is the 1100 block of 28th Street. In the last 2 hours, the fire chief and mayor spoke about the fire. Danny Spiewak was there and starts our team coverage live tonight. Hi, Danny.
Hi there. Well, the fire chief today in Minneapolis credited his department's quick response for saving lives and limiting injuries to just two people today. But the fire chief said, although the cause is still under investigation, he said the conditions of the encampment with propane so close to open flames is really his worst fear as a fire chief in the city. And that is why Mayor Fry came out and said today in the news conference that these encampments are unsafe and should not be allowed to continue in the city. After evicting people from several other locations in South Minneapolis this winter, the city now plans to close and fence off this encampment as well. Fry said that their new partnership with a group known as Helix has helped 100 people from previous encampments find stable housing. Organizers of the encampment now, the current one, estimate that there were about 50 people still remaining and living here at that site, although the city could not verify that number.
What I can tell you is that homeless encampments, especially of this size, are neither safe for the people living there, nor are they safe for the residents in buildings surrounding the homeless encampment itself.
Now, the mayor has made his position clear that he doesn't feel the encampments are safe, but we pressed him on the long-term plan here that the city has, given that these locations of the encampments have just continued to pop up, that there have been three or four of them now at different places in South Minneapolis this winter. He said the city is going to continue to work with Hennepin County and other community partners on these complex solutions. But that's bigger picture. That's the broader issue here. The more immediate was the fire today, and my colleague Jennifer Hoff has more on that.
Thanks, Danny. This latest encampment, this location here, butts up, as you can see, to several residential homes. The hospital is just a couple blocks away, but really it was a construction crew right across the street that prevented this from becoming much worse. Take a look at some of the video from on the scene. One of those workers who saw the fire ran to those houses to try to evacuate anybody who might be inside, saying that fire exploded within seconds and flames grew to 100 feet tall. The camp houses upwards sometimes of 100 people, a mostly indigenous population. There was a tribal member who was actually here conducting interviews for an entirely separate project that we spoke to, but he took some of this video that shows the chaos, it shows the intensity, but also the determination to try to rescue the people inside.
I could feel my hair singeing up, crickling, so there was nothing to do. It was that fire was so bad and it burnt so hot and so quickly, there was no recourse.
What then happened next, and also very quickly, is community outreach. Just a lot of kindness that you saw from grassroots organizations to police officers handing out water, food, and clothing. It really, though, this adds to a lot of the frustration that the folks who are living here and who are helping work here, because they're saying this is a problem that just continues to persist without any either short-term or, as Danny was referring to, long-term solutions. And while we know that two people are hurt and have received medical attention from this explosion and this fire, it's really that mental and emotional toll that will take a lot longer to heal.